Hello dear students, welcome in this online session of 8th standard English medium and the lesson which I already made you to understand in my previous chapter, in my previous lecture, that is the lecture of part 1 and the lesson is This is Jody's Fawn. And the lesson number is 6th here. This is a very interesting lesson. So if you have seen my lecture number 1st of this lesson, because this is the lecture number 2, video lecture number 2. In that lecture, previous lecture, I made you to understand that Mr. Penny, who is the father of Jody, is bitten by a rattlesnake, and now he is actually trying to save in this chapter related to his own theory that how he can save himself. Now when he is bitten by a rattlesnake, he is actually saving himself related to the household remedies. He is killing a fawn, fawn's mother, means he is killing a doe, and he is trying to take out the liver where the doe is dying, and he is actually using its liver to survive himself by making some kinds of tonic and by making some kinds of household, we can say, remedical medicine to here. Now the baby fawn, means the mother is died now, and now the baby fawn is remaining left alone in the jungle with the hunger and all the bad, we can say, other animals to here. So the boy is actually feeling ashamed of that, and he's feeling pity also, and he is feeling mercy towards that baby of that mother, we can say, like the doe. So the boy is asking to his father that, father, should I carry that the small little fawn to my home, to our home? I will make it to get my milk, and after some time it will grow, so it will take care of itself, because I think that we killed his mother and we need to save that kind of fawn. Now it's our responsibility. So the boy is going inside the jungle with a person who is also named as like Uncle Wheel, and he's taking himself and this boy inside the jungle where the baby, means where the baby fawn is not actually, till the lecture number 1 is not found, but now in the lecture number 2, let's check it out whether the boy is finding that fawn in the jungle or not. And he's all alone in the jungle. So now I'm going to start this lecture with the actually lesson part number 3, and the video lecture is 2nd. Let's see what says the part number 3. When the boy was actually inside the jungle, he was trying to find out here and there. He finds some of the buzzards, some of the birds related to the vultures and other birds, also the scavengers who were actually the meat eaters. And it was the rainy season, so last night of the rain has also wiped out, vanished the footprint of the baby fawn, or you can say the footprint of the baby animal. So now it was not about to find out. So the moment actually he went inside the jungle, he was trying to find out here and there alone. He made Uncle Willy also go back, and he was alone inside the jungle, and he also promised to his mom and the uncle that I will be coming back safe, and he also knows how to find out the direction, northeast direction, northwest direction, by the loop of the trees. So he was very smart and pretty sure kind of a person or a boy. Now if we go detailed in the theory of the story, then we can say that the boy is actually trying to turn inside more and more and find out the baby fawn, or find out the fawn here. So the moment in front of him startled him, something was stumbling backward, and something was stumbling from the we can say bushes and all, kuch hil raha tha wahan pe jungle mein. And then he found that the fawn lifted his head. There was the baby fawn. He lifted its head and actually turned his head towards his face, on the boy's face, and he was looking at him. Now with a wider eye he was looking upon his face, and he was not feeling good enough, so he shook him through his startled liquid eye. The boy was looking that small fawn, and the fawn was having the very bright and big eye. So the boy was very eager to see, and now when he saw, he was very happy. So he shook him with his staring liquid eyes, and it was quivering also, shaking slightly. The fawn was shaking slightly, and his eyes were also shaking slightly. It made no effort to rise to run. The Jody could not trust himself to move also. And then Jody was thinking that it is not the right way to go and grab that. He was steady and he was trying to go and catch that kind of small little animal. So he whispered, it's me. He whispered, means the Jody is trying to say that, hey, don't worry, it's me. The fawn lifted his nose by sniffing, you know, like this, we just sniff. So the baby fawn, means the fawn, is sniffing and scenting him, means sniffing him. So he reached out the hands, he is making the hands out there to catch hand, and laid it on the soft neck of the fawn, backside, okay, soft neck, slowly. It is like a gesture where we are trying to make comfortable to any animal, any creature, any kind of living thing actually. So one hand left on his neck, soft neck, and they touched, he actually making him more delirious. Means somehow when he was touching, it was extremely excitement inside the boy also and the fawn too here. Beside it, he put his arms around his body. Now he's grabbing that fawn, okay, grabbing him slowly, and he lifted that fawn. Now he put his arm on its body and light convulsions passing over it, but did not, it was not stir enough, and he stroked him, okay, he stroked that fawn side gently, and through that the fawn, it was like it was now about to be lifted by the boy. And as though the fawn were like we can say like a China deer, he might break it. As he was thinking, like he was lifting that fawn in such a way that it was like a ceramic deer and it will fall and it will break. So you're lifting the fawn very quite carefully. Now he might break. Its skin was very soft enough, according to the boy. His skin was very soft, as you can see in the figure which is given inside the textbook. Now it was sleek and clean also, and had sweet scent of the grass. Now these are the animals which are actually available inside the wild forest. So grass, tree smell will be coming easily from their body parts. So it was a sweet scent of the grass as he was eating also grass. So he rose slowly, the boy is rising slowly, lifted the fawn, and then from the ground it was now in his hand. So now my dear student, you need to understand that the boy is actually trying to catch that animal in his own control, and he is trying to take that to the home. Now its legs hung limply. Limply means very layfully. The leg was hanging there, and they were surprisingly long, and had hoisted also the fawn as the high as possible to under his arms. So now here the legs were downside, it was surprisingly long legs. As you can see, as you might have seen the Discovery Channel or the National Geographic or the Nat Geo also, in which this deer family animals can be seen. Chinkaras are there, cheetahs are there, then doe is there, fawn, and like all the animals are there. They're so cute little animal. So the legs was longer enough. Now he was afraid too that might he could kick that bat at the sight also. Like he was thinking that smell of his mother was still somehow not away from that. So he was thinking that it is not from my body, the smell of his mother is coming. So it may be the possibilities that it could kick me. But so he strike the clear and pushed his way into the thicket here. Now he is trying to make himself to take him home here. So it was a very general thing where he was trying to catch that kind of animal. He was also trying to lift that kind of fawn from his own freedom to his freedom, means from the jungle to his home. And he strike the clearing and pushed his way into the thicket. And also it was difficult actually to take that kind of thing, but he tried to take it out here. So the fawn's legs caught in his bushes and he could not lift his own with his freedom. Again he went back, then again he caught here, and then he tried to shield its all the face from the pricking up the vines also. Means he was trying to hold up the faces to here of the fawn. And laterly its head bobbed with the stride, means the head is actually putting very strong, which is actually hitting him strong slightly because it's trying to grow away from here. So it hurt, thumbed out also. The heart was making some kind of vibration sound, like heart was beating very faster. Whenever, my dear student, you are catching any rabbit, any dog, any kind of animal which is not related to you, they will panic. So from my type, from my side, the suggestion will be that never ever catch any animal directly. They can bite you also, they can kick you also, or they can nudge you also. So better you need to take care of that under the guidance of your parents only. You can try to do these kinds of things, or you should not do this kinds of thing. Okay, so now he tried to shield its face from the prickling vines. The alag-alag, we can say different thorns were there. So he's trying to save his face and the baby's face also, and he's trying to come from here. So he reached the trowel and walked fast and faster by holding the fawn on his shoulder. Now he's trying to keep the fawn on his shoulder. So he stopped also and rested to set the fawn down at the dangling legs. Means the legs were somehow moving, and he was trying to make himself also sit after some walk, because the boy was tired only. Now it wavered on them and looked at if it somehow pelted also. The legs were not looking properly because it was so thin, so belated. So he understood one of the theory that the fawn will be not carried along with him directly. So what he did, he remembered his father. After remembrance of his father, as his father said that, okay, once you lift the fawn and you make him curdle in your arms, and after that if you are leaving the fawn downside, it will follow you. So the boy actually actually came on the same theory of the concept, and he left the fawn down and he tried to follow him. Slowly, slowly the fawn started to follow him. Some of our distance that he was carrying the fawn, and some of the distance he was actually making it to follow him, wobbled him downside. So it was a spring season and the sky was as clear as the cup of a china clay put inside the water, and the temperature is also cool enough as it is described inside the lesson. So the breeze of the chilled air can be felt when the boy was actually exhausted by trying to help this fawn and himself to come out of the jungle to the home here. It was not an easy task, my dear student. Whenever you're trying to carry or call any of the wild animals to make the bonding between them, you need to actually create hard workship and the leadership also. Then only that kind of animals can be having such a bonding with you, and they can be coming closer to you, following you also. So here the Zodi is trying to make fawn to follow him, as his father said that if he'll follow you, it is very best that he is making you a friend also and is trusting you. So the boy is now moving along with the fawn. After some time he is resting also, making his hoof also, and he's trying to make his like breath also very comfortable, as the fawn is also hungry. So he's also feeling very anxious when he's following the boy. Slowly the boy is entering near to the village house. And now when he's actually getting near to the house, he actually got that okay, now a house was very near to him. He was happy to see that fawn was following him. But later bit we can say the fawn was also stopping after some time. Again it was following. Again the boy needed to cuddle himself with the cuddle that fawn in his own arms. And laterly we can see that okay, the house was near, so the boy entered very near to the house. But the fawn stopped to follow him. What was the reason? The reason was that there were the steps which was not actually climbed by the fawn or seen by the fawn anytime inside the jungle. It was a pakka house, and jungle is a wild animal's habitat here. So the fawn was not about to get inside the house, but slowly tried to go over the steps. It fell down. So the boy lifted the fawn directly towards the room of the father, where the father was sleeping. Can you imagine, my dear student, what will happen next? Now when the father was sleeping, the boy thought that I would carry this fawn very easily, and this fawn will be making my father very happy also to see that fawn is there. So he is actually entering inside the father's quarter, and now he is actually asking that, "Dad, Pa, look here, who is there with you?" So now when the boy is actually calling his father like this way, his father was in a deep sleep. So Jodi went inside directly towards his father, and the boys were also as bright as the fawn's eye. It was so bright enough. Both were so happy, according to the text. So the father was feeling very greatness also. Now laterly we can say that the father is telling that I am very proud of you, my dear son. You found this fawn, and now it is in our home. We'll take responsibility of this fawn. Laterly the father is standing over from the bed, and he is trying to touch that fawn also, and now the boy is making the fawn to go with him inside the kitchen to get some amount of meeting with the mom also. So everybody was happy at the time. Now next morning we can say the boy actually allowed the fawn to get some amount of milk. Now the milk was very creamy enough, as you know that, and the fawn is first time watching the milk directly inside the bowl, because it was drinking milk from the direct from his mother. So now the fawn is also hesitating sometime, but the boy is feeling very good enough, and the boy is trying to feed the milk. After the smelling the milk, the fawn is leaving back. He's not trying to drink the milk. So the boy is separating the cream from the milk, and now he's trying to put the fingers, two fingers inside the milk, and he made the fingers to touch over the fawn's very soft mouth. And he was also trying to save the vessel so that fawn should not make that milk to fall down on the floor. So when he's touching that milk over his snort or over the lips of the mouth of that fawn, the fawn is trying to leak that out, and after leaking it is getting a good taste here. So if you talk about the general theory, the fawn is trying to drink that milk, okay, slowly, and the boy is feeling very delighted after seeing this impression created on the fawn, because fawn is now thinking that this is my new home. And slowly the fawn is drinking all the milk from the from the vessel, and nothing, no any drop is left here. So this story is actually ending by the happy ending, and the boy is actually taking care of this fawn. My dear student, one thing is very sure and pretty clear, that if you have mercy in your heart and thought to help anyone related to human being, related to animal, related to bird, creature, reptiles, fish, anything, if you needed to help, even the plant and trees also, then you can and you must go forward. People will help you also, and the inner peace which you'll get from internally will be like value. It cannot be calculated over the money balances. No, it is actually priceless beauty inside what you'll get. So this lesson is treating you that if you are actually seeing any animal which is hurted or alone animal, you need to feed exactly, you need to feed that animal. I'm not telling actually that you need to keep all the animals at your home, but as soon as possible you try to help that kind of animal. If you found a small puppy, you need to help that animal also, because helping other is creating the worship to the God, and we are also feeling very inner peace of the mind, and it is also making us to actually break away from the bad mentality. It is also disconnecting us from the brutal thinkings also, where we can make a good human being inside us. I hope this lesson is interesting, my dear student, and I hope this lesson, which is lesson number 6, this is Zodi's fawn, is also very interestingly creating some kinds of inspiration to you, and you understood the lesson. Now you need to read this lesson by yourself also and get all the detailed theory clear. The glossaries are given there, and until the next lesson is not coming, you can revise this kinds of lessons till here only. Okay, take care. Jai Hind.